If you're someone who puts music in their videos, then you know how important it is to make sure that your visuals match up with your music. But this can be a bit of work because most high quality effects aren't drag and drop, so they take a bit of time to make. But today, I'm gonna teach you not just one, but three time glitch effects that will add more energy into your videos, but also they take less than a minute to make. Hey, my name is Billy Ripka, and I'm here to bring you the top tips, tricks, and how-tos for creating better overall videos. And also, stick around to the end, and I'll tell you how you can get over $150 worth of DaVinci Resolve assets for only 37 bucks. All right, so now in DaVinci Resolve, we're gonna go ahead and make this time skip glitch effect first. So we need to go ahead and mark the places that we want this effect to actually begin and end. So I'll just listen to the song and mark it out by using M on the keyboard. And by the way, this is a custom shortcut, so normally it's double M, but I have my own custom shortcuts. If you wanna know what those are, I'll put a link to the video above. Anyways, after you've marked out the clip, go ahead and duplicate it by holding Control and click and just drag that clip above. Then move the clip over 3 frames to the left because we're gonna be efficient here. Also, just a little side note here, 3 frames is what works well for my clip specifically. So this ain't Canon. You could do whatever you want, all right? So now I'm gonna right click and just change the clip color so that I can tell these clips apart. Now, I wanna make a bunch of cuts on these clips, but the issue is if I make a cut right now, you can see that it's gonna cut the audio also, and I really don't want that to happen. So I can just hit Control Z to undo that, and then I'll turn off the auto track selector right here. So now if I make a cut, you can see that it only cuts these top 2 clips and it bypasses our audio clip. Then once you've asserted dominance over this clip and cut it up a bunch, I'm gonna hold Control so that I can select multiple clips at once and then select every other frame. Now get rid of them by hitting the backspace key. Now all we have left to do is highlight these top clips right here and drag them down and to the left, just like this, so that there's an orange clip every other frame. And then delete the duplicate clips because we don't actually need them anymore. So now we just line it up and we are all good to go. All right, so the second effect that we're gonna do is the reverse time skip effect. And this one is so simple, it's ridiculous. Now, once again, we are gonna mark out the clip, but this time we actually wanna look for a different kind of beat. So instead of this like stuttering beat, which we had earlier, we're gonna listen for a section that has just one note that stands out a lot. So if you just listen to the song for a second, you can hear that there's this one note that stands out. So I'll add a marker at that section and then I'll make a cut on my clip like this and drag it to the second video layer. Then just extend it backwards 4 frames like this and drag it back down to the end of this first clip so that when you listen to it, you get this cool stutter back glitch effect. Of course, you can make it longer than 4 frames if you want to, like do whatever you want, boo. Also, if you're getting value so far, then give this video a like. That'd be dope.
It'd be splendid. That'd be smashing.
All right, so now on to the third effect. Let's just call this the time stutter effect, or the glitch in the matrix if you want. So how we do this is actually pretty simple because it shares a lot of the same similarities of the first effect that we did, meaning that we can actually use the same markers that we had used in the first effect. So whatever part of your footage that you want to be stuttering like in midair or whatever, you're gonna make a cut there. Then move over 1 frame and make another cut. So now you just have a 1-frame section. Now I'm gonna skip 3 more frames or whatever you want and make another 1-frame section. So a cut on each side. And bring together these 1-frame sections and move them to the beginning of the first clip. Then with both highlighted, I'm gonna hold Alt and duplicate. Freaking said that horrible. Oh my gosh. I said duplicate. Then with both highlighted, I'm gonna hold Alt and duplicate these clips a bunch, just pretty much as long as you want this stutter effect to go on. So now when we take a look at it, you can see that this person or whatever footage you have is just flickering in midair. Now, if you want more dope looking effects, then check out our DaVinci Resolve Starter Kit. It comes with 7 of our most popular packs that will give you over 90 assets and 140 sound effects. Plus, you'll get a video starter guide that'll teach you all about using DaVinci Resolve. Now, normally it's $150, but right now you can get that for only $37. So I'll drop a link to that in the description. Anyways, if you want more videos like this, then click on the top for the awesome ink drop effect video, or click on the bottom for a video that YouTube thinks that you would like. But until the next one, peace.